I will try to share the last 30 years in a few minutes. We started out with the airline industry. At Northwest Airlines in the beginning was looking for a revenue management solution to capture their entire network effect. What that means is that instead of optimizing each flight leg in isolation, you want to optimize your profits and revenues across the network. And it was a very difficult problem because most of the people were happy with optimizing each flight leg in isolation. The complexity of this problem, if you imagine a flight coming into Minneapolis, is carrying passengers in 10 fare classes, and people can be connecting to any of the 50 destinations. There are 500 different kinds of things traveling on this flight, which has only 100 seats. How will you divvy up 100 seats among 500 different things? This was an impossible task, and American and United had found a roundabout solution for it, which wasn't working very properly. This is where the seeds of opportunity cost approach or bid price approach were born. Yes, sir.
The nemesis of ideas.
That we said 30 years ago, you're not in the business of allocations, you're not in the business of taking seats and allocating them, you're only in the business of making decisions. If a person wants to travel from here to there, number one, do you want that passenger? Number two, if so, at what price?
And what was the moment when you got into the hotel business?
Well, we decided to become a product company and wanted to bring a product to the market. And when I looked around, we thought that hotels, according to us, were not being run the way that they should have been run, and there a product could make all the difference. So we started with Shangri-La and Hilton as our first clients, and there again, now how has the revenue management problem changed? Think about it. In the beginning, things were simple. People had these prices that they establish, and it was how many of these do you sell to which segment. Now, as things became more complicated, it became clear that you could be focusing on one aspect of your business, let's say your rooms, and you can do an extremely good job of selling your rooms, but when somebody who would use your function space or somebody who would give you a lot of food and beverage, they come along, they need rooms to go with it that you have sold at very high prices to people who bought only rooms. Yeah. So the total revenue management problem is still at where people struggle with it. Still there are no automated solutions. And the reason for that essentially is that pricing is not something that is a very obvious answer. People can talk to you about machine learning. People can talk to you about data. People can say that data tells you the entire story. But the problem is that any data that you get from a hotel has been influenced by the previous practices of the hotel. If the hotel is going to achieve things in the future that is different from the past, then they have to work differently. But the data that has been influenced by the past, I'll give you a very simple example. When the demand is very, very, very strong, even human beings will charge high prices, and despite that, they will fill up. When the demand is very, very, very anemic, humans are going to charge low prices, and despite that, they will not fill up. So if an alien came and looked at the data and plotted the occupancy as a function of the prices paid, they will find that the higher the prices charged by the hotel, the more people stayed at the hotel. But that is not the price sensitivity of demand. And therefore, any machine learning and things like that that you use directly on data can lead you into a problem. So we have to have a scientific measure. We have to take a view where we have to realize that data does not always tell you the whole story and sometimes can tell you the wrong story. But there are scientific ways of looking at data in an unencumbered environment, and our ability to solve complex problems is increasing rapidly more than the complexity of the business problem itself. So although the business problem is becoming very complex, our ability to solve it, so we therefore in a good shape where we can take revenue management, and as the real world problem changes, we can continue to modify the solution, and that is what makes this field very exciting. It's not stagnant. The revenue management problems of the future are going to be very different, and revenue management 5 years from now will not be something that you will recognize today.
So what would it be then? Summarized
human beings make decisions through gut. And when you ask them to rely upon an automated system or a black box that is not consistent with their gut, they can have trouble. But the amount of data that needs to be processed, that will need to be processed in the future, will be so enormous that it will not be the capacity of the human being to be able to do any kind of pricing. So all this pricing, I think, will be taken over by machines. The problem that people may face is, hey, if the machines are going to take over the pricing and these aspects, then what will humans do? Remember, humans will always be ahead of the machines. The machines are designed by who? The humans, to do what they do best. Would you like to add a million numbers using a calculator or without one? Okay? So what the human beings will do in the future is something that will evolve as well. And it will be very interesting to see how the humans will elevate themselves so that the mundane things, the things that humans are not naturally good at, are being done by machines more and more, and maybe there is no human involvement in pricing. And what the humans will be doing has yet to be seen, but I can tell you it will be very exciting.